Kenya's main opposition political coalition, NASA, or National Super Alliance, has filed its petition to challenge the election of President Uhuru Kenyatta. NASA was making its allegations that the votes were rigged by the Jubilee Party. Elections, if the NASA coalition wins the case within the next 14 days, when it will be determined by the Supreme Court, then elections will be held within 60 days. The Kenya National Human Rights Commission has indicated that at least 24 lives were lost after the police and the NASA supporters collided in Mathare, in Kibera, and other areas. The NASA coalition will be represented by James Orengo, or is likely to be represented by James Orengo, Paulo Mwangi. James Orengo is a senior counsel. Then there's Paulo Mwangi, George Oraro, Pen Sihanya, Willis Otieno, Jackson Awele. James Orengo, Paulo Mwangi, and George Oraro represented CORD in 2013 presidential petition. The Jubilee Party will be represented by senior lawyers Katwa Kigen, Fred Ngatia, Kithure Kindiki, who is a senator for one of the senators, Mohamed Nyaoga, Kithure Kindiki, Mohamed Nyaoga, Ahmedin Nasir Abdullahi are going to represent the Jubilee Party. IPC will be is likely to be represented by Paul Mwite, among others. A number of political analysts have indicated that the reversal of IBC's declaration might be difficult. One of those who believes that, or one of the analysts who says that, is Ombati Omwanza, a Nairobi-based constitutional lawyer. He said, and I quote, "They could be very cautious to upset the status quo unless the opposition put up very good evidence to demonstrate that it wasn't fair. Elections are very disruptive to the economy, and the Supreme Court is aware of what a reversal could mean." That is Ombati Omwanza speaking in terms of how the Supreme Court is likely to respond to the case. Others who are saying that the case might not go on as expected, that NASA might not win, are Patrick Lumumba, the director of Kenya School of Law, Ahmed Nasir Abdullahi, a lawyer based in Nairobi, Patrick Gatara, an independent political analyst. They all said that the court will rule against NASA. Those are just the updates on the case which has been filed in court by NASA, the main political opposition in Kenya. The next item of news. Yesterday we mentioned that the former Vice President of the United States of America, Al Gore, had been asked to give one advice to the current president, Donald Trump, and what he said is resign. Just a one-word answer, resign. But one, Jeffrey Wundrak of Tapuran Capital, chief executive, has said that it will not be possible for Donald Trump to resign unless his support falls below 20%. So it's not possible, according to Jeffrey Wundrak, won't drag for President Trump to resign unless the support goes below 20%. Currently, the Trump's job approval rating is at 39%, according to a compilation by Really Clear Politics. This has moved down from 44% when he was inaugurated in January. So there is a drop from 44% to 39%. I have a full table here. So the average is 39%, but different pollsters have produced different results. According to Gallup, approval is 38%, disapproval is 57%. So a lot of people in the United States disapprove Donald Trump's presidency. According to Rasmussen reports, approval is 42%, disapproval is 57%. According to Marist, approval is 38%, disapproval is 51%. According to Economist, EU government, approval is 42%, disapproval is 54%. Reuters says approval is 35%, disapproval is 58%. Monmouth says approval is 42%, disapproval is 49%. CBS News says approval is 36%, disapproval is 58%. On average, Donald Trump's approval is 39%, disapproval is 55.1%. So that is it. It is said, someone has said that Donald Trump will not resign anytime soon unless his approval rating goes below 20%. We have a new e-passport. The old passport, this is my passport, the old one, will no longer be used. The immigration department has announced that they have a new passport. This one might not be used anymore. So the new e-passport has a microchip which contains the information, the data about the holder of that passport. That is the difference. This is just a booklet. It cannot be used electronically. It's just a booklet. This is a booklet where whenever you reach the entry or exit points from one country to another, they just stamp on that given page. But now we are entering the digital part of the passports, which we call e-passports. It is said that the applicants must present themselves at the immigration offices for taking of biometrics. So if you are planning to have an e-passport, probably you have an old one like mine, which I've just shown you. If you need the new one, you would have to go to the immigration offices for taking of biometrics, that is fingerprints, photos, we call them passports, and others. You will pay a fee of 4,500 for the 32 pages, and the 64 pages you will pay 6,050. The processing fee will, or the processing period will be 10 days. The features include it has a new logo. There is a blue color scheme. They chose the blue color scheme because it represents Lake Victoria, which is a unifying factor in the EAC. It will also be written East African Community as opposed to Kenya. Now this is an e-passport for the East African Community. The benefits are that there will be faster clearance in the point of entry and exit. So that is all we have for you today about the logos, about the passports, about the filing of the petition of election results in Kenya, and about President Trump's job approval, which is falling very fast. It is on the it's on downhill. Sorry. Thank you for tuning in to Kerosi TV. Now, kindly subscribe to our channel, Kerosi TV. There is a subscription button below, somewhere here or here. You will see it. Subscribe. and also click on the bell-shaped button so that every time we post a new episode, you get a notification. Thank you very much.